going to show you something quite neat. It's called operational properties. So I might know the Laplace transform of the f of t, but what if I multiply that f of t by e to the power a t? So I can have, well, we'll look at an example after this. Now instead of doing, it can become very onerous to do these Laplace transforms. There's a simple way though, and if you multiply f of t by e to the power a t, that becomes the f of, not s, but s minus a. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. So if I were to ask the Laplace transform of e to the power 3t times, for instance, t to the power 3. T times t to the power 3, t cubed, what would that be? Well, first of all, I note that a equals 3 here, a equals 3, and I know what the Laplace transform is of the f of t here, which is the Laplace transform of t to the power 3, and here I have n equals 3, so for me this is going to be 3 factorial divided by s to the power n plus 1, so that's 4, so I'm going to have 6 over s to the power 4. Okay, so I have the Laplace transform of the f of t being 6 over s to the power over s to the power 4, and I have this a equal to 3, so everywhere where I hit the s, everywhere where I have s, I just have to replace that with s minus 4. I just have to replace every s, f of s, that was f of s, now s minus a, s minus 4. So the Laplace transform of this whole thing is now going to be 6 over, and in place of s, I'm going to have s minus a 4. S minus 3 to the power 4. So just instead of that s, I now have s minus a, which is s minus 3 to the power 4. If I had to do this the long, remember that's going to be the improper integral of e to the power negative st times e to the power 3t times t to the power 3 dt. Now, at least with these, it's quite easy because I can rewrite this as the this improper integral of e to the power, I can have minus s minus 3 t times t to the power 3 dt. I can have that, which I'll now have to run through various, setting that equal to my u and this to my this part to my v prime with a product rule. Then I'll have a t squared, then I'll have a t to the power 1, eventually t to the power 0. So I'll have this long pages and pages full of doing this improper integral. Instead, I can just use this property. If I multiply f of t by e to the power at, I can just replace, just do my f of t, do my normal Laplace transform of the f of t, and wherever I see a s, I just substitute it with s minus a, which is here was s minus 3.